nhau để buổi lễ được diễn ra tốt đẹp. In the unlikely event there is an emergency, we have a medical center located in the building on your left hand side. If the fire alarm sounds, please make your way to the nearest exit. Trong trường hợp khẩn cấp, chúng tôi có trung tâm y tế nằm bên tay trái của tòa nhà. Trong trường hợp có chuông báo cháy, quý khách vui lòng sử dụng lối thoát hiểm gần nhất. Please do not leave your belongings unattended. Xin quý khách vui lòng lưu ý đồ đạc tư trang của mình. Please do not approach the stage area to take photos during the ceremony, as this impedes the movement of graduates to and from the stage. Professional photographers will be taking photos when graduates receive their awards on the stage. Để không ảnh hưởng tới trình tự của buổi lễ, trong suốt quá trình diễn ra, xin quý khách giữ nguyên chỗ ngồi và không chụp hình các tân khoa trên sân khấu. Nhà trường đã có thợ chụp ảnh chuyên nghiệp cho các tân khoa khi lên sân khấu nhận bằng. The ceremony will begin with a drum performance. Buổi lễ sẽ bắt đầu với màn biểu diễn chống nghệ thuật.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the Vietnamese and Australian national anthems.
Representatives from high schools and universities in Hanoi. But more importantly, I would like to acknowledge our graduating students, as well as your friends and family members who have helped you on this journey. Today is the day you graduate and begin a new era in your life. It's pretty exciting, and what an achievement to reach this milestone. This is a wonderful accomplishment. However, it is not yours alone. And sometime today, I would like you to thank the important people in your life. Your families and friends have supported you towards achieving this goal. I know that you'll be approaching this graduation day with mixed feelings. On the one hand, you will be understandably proud of your achievement, but also, no doubt, you'll be experiencing some relief. No more studying on weekends, no more stress before exams, no more struggling to make it to that early morning class. There will also, no doubt, be sadness at leaving campus life and daily contact with your friends. And what has become your second home? At this second home, there have been a large number of people, both academic and professional staff, who have been committed to you achieving your full potential. Their dedication has been to the development of not just the technical skills associated with your degree, but also the development of you as a person. Like your family, they are here today to celebrate your achievement. In many ways, it may feel as though your time has gone by far more quickly than you would have imagined it would. But that whirlwind feeling is a sign of it being a truly full experience. You are a different person now than you were at the beginning of your journey with RMIT. RMIT Vietnam has also been growing and developing, ensuring that our range of programs continues to reflect the needs of industry and that our teaching is of the highest quality. This year has been a good year for RMIT, with our commencing numbers increasing for the third year in a row. In fact, our October intake is the highest ever for semester three. Our commitment to Vietnam remains central to our operation. In 2017, we've introduced a number of new programs which will contribute significantly to the development of this country. New programs include bachelor's degrees in tourism and hospitality management, design studies, digital marketing, and languages. To foster the rapid growing spirit of entrepreneurship in Vietnam, we will also soon be introducing a graduate certificate in business startups. And there will be more programs in 2018. Our commitment to digitization continues, and in 2017 we're focused on the elimination of hard copy textbooks in favor of more contemporary digital content. We've also launched the new learning management system called Canvas to make learning and teaching easier. The mixed reality lab and two new engineering labs are also highlights of 2017, because we want to ensure that our students get access to the latest resources and technology. So our priority has been to produce graduates who stand out and make a difference in this world. Graduates like you. Our journey together, however, doesn't stop here, and we hope that you may return to us for further study as you progress in your careers. After today, you are an RMIT alumni and a member of a global alumni community with over 400,000 alumni around the world. So we will be keeping in touch with you. Now, I'm sure you're excited to get on with the ceremony, so in closing, on behalf of RMIT University, once again, congratulations to you all on the successful completion of your degree. Gan mai.
The Deputy Chancellor of RMIT University, Ms. Janet Letchford, will now conduct the conferring ceremony. This is the formal part of the graduation, where the Registrar presents a list of authorised candidates to the Chancellor. She then takes the list and, on behalf of the Council of RMIT University, confers the award of degrees, at which time you move from being a graduate to a graduate.
I call on Mr. Huma Can, Registrar of RMIT University, Vietnam, for the certification of awards.
Graduates, would you please stand for the conferring of degrees? Chancellor, I certify to you that the candidates presented here today and the candidates whose names appear on the list for awards in absentia have fulfilled the conditions prescribed for admission to awards of the Royal Melbourne Institute of Technology and are entitled to be admitted to the rights and privileges of these awards.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Council of RMIT University, I admit the duly authorised candidates on this list, both present and absent, to the appropriate degree or diploma of RMIT University and to all the rights and privileges of graduation. Congratulations to our new graduates.
Graduates, as a symbol of having graduated, you may now move the tassel the right side of your friendship to the left, and you may now be seated.
It is now time for the presentation of an honorary doctoral degree. Please welcome the Vice President and Academic of RMIT University of Vietnam, Professor Beverly Webster.
Is a time-honoured tradition. It is a time when the university gathers to recognise a member of the community who has excelled in their chosen field and made an outstanding contribution to society. Recipients of an honorary doctorate are receiving the highest honour from the university, a degree honoris causa. These are people who have striven to improve the lives of others through their leadership, their commitment to their profession, and to the community as a whole. Chancellor, it is my pleasure and my privilege to present to you Mr. Nguyen Quan Bang, whom you have admitted to the degree of Doctor of Social Sciences, honoris causa. Mr. Bang is the former Director General, Vietnam International Education Cooperation Department, Ministry of Education and Training. Mr. Bang received his education in English studies, applied linguistics, and teaching English to speakers of other languages in Vietnam, the UK, and Australia. He is experienced in teaching English for specific purposes, conference interpreting, translation, and international cooperation. He has extensive hands-on experience in higher education. He was appointed Vice President of Hanoi University of Foreign Studies in 1997 and then President in 2000. He was President for two terms, 2000 to 2008, and has made outstanding contributions to change Hanoi University of Foreign Studies to Hanoi University in 2006. Hanoi University was the first Vietnamese university to offer full curricula in English in 2002. Mr. Bang moved to work at the Ministry of Education and Training in 2008 and has served as Director General of Vietnam International Education Development, then the International Cooperation Department, and recently the Vietnam International Education Cooperation Department. With nearly 40 years of dedication to education, Mr. Bang's contributions have been recognised by prestigious awards, honorary degrees, and titles from Australia, China, Brazil, Italy, Laos, New Zealand, the EU, and Vietnam. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Nguyen Quan Bang.
I will now deliver an acceptance speech.
Ms. Janet Edgeford, Deputy Chancellor, Professor Gil McDonald, RMIT Vietnam President, RMIT Vietnam Board Members, graduates and families, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is a great pleasure for me to be at this graduation ceremony. It is also a great honor for me to receive this prestigious award of an honorary doctorate from RMIT University, and I feel privileged to be asked to speak to you today. First of all, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to the Council of RMIT University for this notable award. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate RMIT Vietnam for your outstanding achievement for nearly two decades now. RMIT has been the first international university ever established in Vietnam, and I have the pleasure to witness RMIT growth and development since its establishment in the year 2000. I am delighted to say that RMIT Vietnam is now very well positioned in the higher education sector in Vietnam. RMIT Vietnam couldn't have obtained such outstanding achievements without the dedication, devotion, and efforts of all the generations of management, faculty, and staff of the university. So please accept my appreciation and congratulations to you all who have together contributed to make Vietnam, RMIT Vietnam, as it is today. Now let me extend my warmest congratulations to the main characters for today's ceremony, the graduates and their families, who have made the right choice to study at a world-class university in Vietnam. Today is one of their happiest days and a turning point in their life, so please join me in giving a round of applause to the graduates with their families and their families. Thank you very much. Dear graduates, I'm sure that you and your families are relieved today because you have completed your course of study, and this is one of the best ways you show gratitude to your families. I have two children, and I know how parents feel when their children complete the first college degrees, and the academic success of our sons and daughters is no doubt the most rewarding return of gratitude to parents. And as a parent, teacher, and senior manager, I would like to give you some advice today as a result of my own experience and observations. First, believe in yourself. Self-confidence is the word that we often say, and it means believe in yourself and your abilities. You must believe in yourself first, before other believes in you. And the best way to gain self-confidence is to look deep inside yourself and believe that you have the ability and to overcome all the obstacles and challenges that you are faced with. Theodore Roosevelt, the 26th US President, has a very famous saying, and would like to quote it here: believe you can, and you're halfway there. So self-confidence alone brings you halfway of any work you're doing. Second, continue to study. In order to gain self-confidence, you must have all the knowledge and required skills. So there is no other way than continue studying. There are many other things out there that you have to learn in order to cope with and survive in this changing world. The first thing is that you should continue perfecting your English. It is no doubt clear that your English should be good enough to receive your degrees from this prestigious university. But I'm sure that this is not yet adequate. You all know that we are living in the era of globalization, and English has become the international language and the most important communication tool. Has English become your second language? For some of you, it may be yes, but for most of you, it is only a foreign language. So keep on studying to make it your second language. Perfect your pronunciation, intonation, improve your idiomatic usage, improve your listening, speaking, reading, writing skills, and why not learn translation and interpretation? Someday, you may be asked to translate to your boss. Who knows? The workplace is very competitive nowadays, and these English skills will surely be your pluses for your job security and promotion. And they will be especially important if you work overseas or for international companies. Teaching English is my life career, but believe me that I'm still learning it every day. There are lots of things I have to learn. So make your plans as soon as possible to improve your English. You can easily do it yourself now, but you have to do it yourself, because no one else except yourself can do it for you to acquire these English skills. Make your plans to quickly spend some time every day to practice these skills and build it in your daily routine. Read books, newspapers in English, watch TV, movies, and there are many other ways to improve your English, and there is also plenty of resources on the internet and mobile applications. So pull up your efforts and determination, believe in yourself, you can do it, you can perfect your English. Nothing is impossible if you have self-discipline and work hard, and I hope you will be able to speak English better than me. Graduates, we are now living in the 21st century, and the second thing I would like you to learn to continue studying, that is the skills for the 21st century. Have you got all these skills mastered for the 21st century? You have not mastered these skills. You have got to learn them, you have got to have them, because these skills are very important for you to succeed in life. So what are these 21st century skills? It is very easy to remember. The four letter C's, including communication, collaboration, creativity, and critical thinking. In Vietnam, you may hear people often refer to these as soft skills, and it's all required for us for our holistic development and capability of adapting to change. Of course, there are other skills you also need, which may be embedded in those four letter C's, such as learning skills, people skills, social skills, digital skills, work skills, etc. And in order to succeed in life, you have to master all these skills among many other things. The third advice I would like to give you is do what you love and love what you do. Now you have graduated, you can do what you love to do. You may work for a company or government, or you may work, you want to start your own business. But whether you choose, just love what you do. Confucius, a great Chinese philosopher, said, wherever you go, go with your heart. So when you have chosen a career, enjoy it, love it, put your heart in it, but remember to focus on implementation. I remember when I was made vice president of Hanoi University. I was asked to be in charge of logistics and research for the university. Research was fine with me, but logistics was totally a different thing for an English teacher like me. But I told myself that I had to be in it. I had to put my heart in it, and my efforts was recognized and appreciated by the university academics and staff, and they decided to vote for me to be their president only after 3 years. I'm sure that every one of you here gets my message across, and you also know what I mean. If you complete your work just as to finish it, or if you complete your work with your heart in it, your boss will certainly know it, and it will affect your career path. In my career, I have had many people under me, and it is very easy to tell the difference between ordinary employees from the dedicated ones. I'm sure you can do this easily. This is also a way to build your personal credibility, charisma, or reputation, and this is very important in life, to win trust and respect from other people. What else do you want more, other than trust and respect of other people? This may be considered as happiness, don't you think so? Graduates, you have a wide open road ahead and many opportunities, but lots of challenges. You are on your own. You have brains in your head, feet in your shoes, and you know what you know. But remember that it's you, your very self, to make your choice, and whatever choice you make, it is entirely yours. And I hope the advice could be of some value to you. To conclude my speech, again, I would like to offer my warmest congratulations to your individual achievements, but beyond that, my respect and congratulations to your parents and families. Without them and their support, we wouldn't have been able to do what we have done today. There is a long way ahead of you, and I'd like to wish you all a happy journey in life. Once again, congratulations and thanks to RMIT Vietnam for their contribution to human resource development in Vietnam. And thank you again for allowing me to speak today. Thank you all, and may I wish you all good health, happiness and success. May God bless you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Van, and congratulations to you again. The President's Award goes to the undergraduate student who embodies all that we would wish our graduates to exemplify: high academic achievement, social responsibility, and service to the university community. The 2017 President's Award for the Hanoi campus goes to Yung Hong Nhung. I'd like to invite the President of RMIT Vietnam, Professor Gao McDonald, to present Nhung with this award. Following the presentation, Nhung will say a few words.
Deputy Chancellor, Professor Gail McDonald, RMIT Vietnam President, and RMIT Board Members. Good morning, lecturers, family, friends, and fellow graduates. It's my honor to be here today on behalf of all RMIT students to give my thoughts on this very special day. Let me introduce myself. My name is Dương Hồng Nhung, graduate of Bachelor of Business, majoring in international business. Currently, I am working for Unilever Vietnam as a management trainee. First of all, I'd like to say congratulations to all of us graduates for our tremendous achievement in the last 3 years. And so here we are, sometime within 3 and however many years it took, leaving university. I'd like to invite all of you to take a few seconds, close your eyes, and think about yourself of 3 years ago. What are 3 adjectives that describe you the most? What have you done in the last 3 years? And now, open your eyes, look yourself a person about to graduate from university. What has changed? What has stayed? I'm sure that there will be so many interesting, different, untold stories out there, and I'd like to hear them all. And to me, reflecting my university time, what makes me remember the most is the journey to see myself grow and unlock my potentials. Today, I would like to share to all of you 3 stories of mine, which are about 3 biggest changes when I became an RMIT student. The first lesson is, there is not always such things as a self-made success. Sometimes it needs a combination of hours' effort and a strong spirit of teamwork. Before I joined RMIT, I always think that I can do it on my own, I can do it by myself. But it was my greatest mistake. For the last 3 years at RMIT, while working on group assignments, exchanging ideas in the library, and then celebrating together when we receive an HD, I realized the importance of working as a team. Not only did we try our best, work hard and go, but also we had a chance to learn from each other. At RMIT, I felt very fortunate that I was surrounded with talented people who challenged convention, offered new ideas, and relentlessly drive for improvement. And we formed a group of 4 with our supporting mentor, who is also our sister, to participate in nursing case competition. We had ups and downs, staying up all night, cracking the case. arguing a lot to find the best solutions to the case, and even sharing our life stories. We did not make it to be the champion, but we have learned from each other a lot, both personally and professionally. And thank you guys so much for being part of my amazing university life. The second lesson, which is also the thing I'm proud of the most when I say I'm an RIT student, is authenticity. Here it means doing things by yourself, staying true to yourself, and daring to talk about what you believe. When I was in high school, I was so reserved and did not open to the outside world. I like following what has been said and done because I feel safe to do so. But I have changed. I still remember Mr. Mark Peterson, our lecturer of entrepreneur course, always challenged us with a very simple question. Why not? If you do not have the belief in yourself, who else will bet on you? Do what you think is right to do and you are passionate about. That philosophy has inspired me a lot to fulfill my desire to do something different, to very first time initiate to create impacts on the society. And then I built my own nonprofit organization, crafting the idea of school inside hospitals. For art and music, we teach children about history, culture, and even academic knowledge. And after 2 years, I applied the model to 4 biggest hospitals in Hanoi, developed the organization from only 5 to 120 members, gaining from only $10 to sustain a financial source every year. Upskilling activities from not only weekend classes in Hanoi, but also different social activities and campaigns across North regions in Vietnam. Expand reputation to become a well-known organization in Hanoi for children and get acknowledgement from reputable media. However, change in children themselves are what worth mentioning the most. At first, they feel hesitant to answer questions. They even cry and look for their parents. But after a few weeks, they became more engaged and concentrated. Change in those kids inspired me to continue what I believe in and do it on my own. And the last story is about being fearless. Have the courage to take risks, go where there are no guarantees, get out of your comfort zone, even somewhere it means really uncomfortable. What you need to prepare is a fearless mind and a careful attitude to overcome all challenges ahead. To be honest, when I was a child, I had some health issues that my mother did not allow me to participate in any activities that she considered unsafe. And it seems that I used it as an excuse to refuse getting out of my comfort zone to do something different. Surrounded by many talented, energetic, and creative minds at RMIT, I think if I did not change, I would be left behind. So instead of concentration on studies only, I challenged myself to do the best of both worlds, getting good results at school, but at the same time, learn more, involve more, experience more to discover my full potentials. At RMIT, I can access to many interesting sources of information and get support from my peers, my professors, and RMIT staffs to assist my learning at school. Also, I engage more with university activities by contributing to student ambassador team as a project leader, participating in voluntary activities organized by RMIT Student Recruitment Department. And thanks to those experiences, I have sharpened my skill of organization, leadership, and time management. My journey would not be complete without valuable support from all RMIT lecturers, friends, and family. I would like to say thank you to all my lecturers, Mr. Kieran Tierney, Mr. Mark Peterson, Mr. Roger Edward, Mr. Tanapat Kibumru, and other lecturers for your advice and support, and also your inspirational lectures that have saved me as today. And also a big thank you to all my amazing teammates. Without your active contribution and excellent ideas, we have not made it this far. And last but not least, I would like to express my gratitude to to my parents, for their absolute trust in my ability, for their encouragement and support to let me follow what I wish for, and to the most influential person in every decision of my life, my sister. Thank you very much for guiding and helping me to achieve my goals. After graduation, I kept those values and key lessons that I learned from RIT to pursue my career path. I decided to take a leap of faith and accept new challenge, starting my journey as a management trainee at Unilever Vietnam. I know that the world outside may be scary, tough, and super competitive, but I believe with your identity, your true values, nothing is impossible. Infuse your life with action. Don't wait for it to happen. Make it happen. Make your own future. Make your own hope. And whatever your beliefs, honor your creator, not by passively waiting for the grace come down from up on high, but by doing what you do to make the grace happen. Yourself, right now, and right here. To end my speech, I'd like to send my every good wish for all that comes hereafter. And once again, congratulations to all of you, class of 2017. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Newman. Congratulations once again. Ladies and gentlemen, before we move to the presentation of degrees, please enjoy the performance of our student, Nguyen Khan Ha, singing A Moment Like This. behalf of their great performance. It is now time to recognise our graduates for 2017. Chancellor, Provost Chancellor and Vice President of the College of Business, Professor Ian Palmer, will now present the doctoral award.
Chancellor, I have the honour to present the graduates whom you have admitted to the doctoral degree for 2017. Today, we are indeed fortunate to be able to celebrate and recognise the achievements of our doctoral graduate. The years of dedication to her research within her field contributes invaluable knowledge for the communities within which we operate. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Dao Hong Nguyen. Dr. Nguyen investigated the influence of public-private partnerships on partnering private firms. Her study revealed that public-private partnerships helped these firms enhance investment efficiency, market return, and external financing across various levels of government support and institutions. The findings provide an insight into the corporate finance dimensions of public-private partnerships. Chancellor, Dr. Dao Hong Nguyen.
Head of the School of Business and Management, will now present graduates from the College of Business. I would like to invite the lecturers from the School of Business and Management to move to the right of the stage to celebrate the achievements of your graduates.
Business. For the degree of Master of International Business with distinction.
Thạc sĩ kinh doanh quốc tế loại giỏi. Nguyễn Phương Dung. Nguyễn Vinh Bảo, and finally, Trương Thị Luân Thủy.
International Business.
Thạc sĩ kinh doanh quốc tế Nguyễn Tuấn Huy.
Quay ơi, chạy đi quay ơi.
And finally, Vi Đức Anh.
Bachelor of Business Accountancy with distinction.
Cử nhân kinh doanh kế toán loại giỏi. Hoàng Thu Hương. Hoàng Trọng Hiếu. Nguyễn Vân Anh. And finally, Phạm Khắc Thành.
For the degree of Bachelor of Business Accountancy.
Cử nhân kinh doanh kế toán. Nghiêm Lý Hồng. Nguyễn Hồng Hương. Nguyễn Quốc Hùng. Nguyễn Thị Ngọc Linh. Quách Thị Bảo Yến. And finally, Trịnh Quốc Việt.
For the degree of Bachelor of Business, Economics and Finance with distinction.
Cử nhân kinh doanh, kinh tế và tài chính, loại giỏi. Kiều Duy Anh. Nguyễn Thị Thủy. Phạm Khánh Linh.
Chào à.
Phạm Thu Anh. Trần Bình Minh. And finally, Vũ Minh Tú.
For the degree of Bachelor of Business, Economics and Finance.
Cử nhân kinh doanh, kinh tế và tài chính. Đặng Hạnh Như. Đặng Huy Cường. Đinh Gia Bảo. Đinh Hương Giang. Dương Vũ Tân Nguyên. Hoàng Thành Long. Hoàng Tùng Vũ. Mai Ngọc Hường. Ngô Hải Anh. Nguyễn Diệu Huyền. Nguyễn Đức Hùng. Nguyễn Phương Linh. Nguyễn Tất Thành.
Học hồ rồi, học RMIT.
Nguyễn Thu Thảo. Phan Thị Hồng Nga. Phạm Thị Thu Trang. Tạ Quỳnh Anh. Tô Quang Tuệ. Trần Mạnh Duy. Trần Xuân Bảo. And finally, Vũ Phan Anh.
For the degree of Bachelor of Business Entrepreneurship.
Cử nhân kinh doanh khởi nghiệp. Nguyễn Vũ Hiệp.
with a degree of Bachelor of Business, International Business with distinction.
Cử nhân kinh doanh quốc tế loại giỏi. Dương Hồng Nhung. Nguyễn Đức Dũng. Nguyễn Minh Anh. Nguyễn Thu Hà. And finally, Trịnh Thùy Dương.
With a degree of Bachelor of Business, International Business.
Cử nhân kinh doanh quốc tế. Đặng Hương Linh. Đinh Viết Tuấn Anh. Đỗ Thanh Hằng. Hàn Trung Kiên. Nguyễn Hoàng Trung. Nguyễn Mỹ Linh. Nguyễn Phương Thảo. Nguyễn Thị Như Quỳnh. Phạm Hoàng Hiệp. Phạm Thế Quyền. Phạm Việt Mỹ. Quách Minh Quang.
And finally,
Chen Huang Ai.
For the degree of Bachelor of Business Management with Distinction.
Cử nhân kinh doanh quản trị loại giỏi. Trần Khánh Quang.
For the degree of Bachelor of Business Management.
Cử nhân kinh doanh quản trị Nguyễn Hoàng Anh. Nguyễn Quang Minh. Nguyễn Thế Đại Dương. Nguyễn Trung Kiên. Phan Thu Hương.
And finally,
Trịnh Nghĩa Đức.
Degree of Bachelor of Business Marketing with Distinction.
Cử nhân kinh doanh marketing loại giỏi. Nguyễn Minh Anh.
And finally,
Nguyễn Thu Hương.
With a degree of Bachelor of Business Marketing.
Cử nhân kinh doanh marketing. Bùi Bích Thảo. Đặng Đức Lâm. Hàn Nhật Thiện. Lê Đặng Hoàng Tùng. Lê Trung Nghĩa.
Nguyễn Phát Kiều. Nguyễn Phú Tài. Nguyễn Tiến Hưng. Nguyễn Thu Ngân. Nguyễn Thủy Anh. Nguyễn Tùng Anh. Nguyễn Viết Hoàng Minh Khánh. Phạm Thị Anh Thư. Trần Anh Đức. Trần Kiên Trang. Trịnh Phương Thảo. Trịnh Quang Anh. Trương Thành Đức. Vũ Hoàng Thanh Tiến. Vũ Thanh Hà.
And finally,
Vương Lan Hương.
For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce.
Cử nhân thương mại. Bùi Duy Thái. Đặng Trần Lan Vi.
Anh hỏi tăng ISO giúp anh vừa đẩy khẩu lên, không cần là ISO thấp. 当好问题。
林冠敦安。中哈俊。 Phạm Thị Phương Hoa. Trần Thanh Long. Chị Ngọc Mai Trang. Congratulations to all graduates. Councillor, that concludes my presentation on graduates from the College of Business.
Councillor, Professor Rick Bennett, Head of School of Communication and Design, will now present graduates from the College of Design and Social Context. I would like to invite the lecturers of the School of Communication and Design to move to the right of the stage to celebrate the achievement of your graduates. Chancellor, I have the honour to present graduates from the College of Design and Social Context. For the degree of Bachelor of Communication, Professional Communication with Distinction.
Cử nhân truyền thông chuyên nghiệp loại giỏi. Đặng Diệu Linh. Đặng Ngân Hà. Nguyễn Phương Linh. Nguyễn Thu Hiền. Nguyễn Tuấn Phong. And finally, Nhữ Thị Thu Hiền. Thank you.
for the degree of Bachelor of Communication, Professional Communication.
Cử nhân truyền thông chuyên nghiệp. Bùi Lê Vân. Bùi Thanh Tuyền. Đào Việt Trung. Đỗ Hải Nam. Đỗ Ngọc Diệp. Đỗ Phương Hải Ly. Đỗ Thành Đạt. Đoàn Việt Hùng. Dương Hạnh Ngân. Hoàng Thanh Hà. Hoàng Việt.
Chắc có nhận bằng chưa? Đúng họ tên luôn.
Ngô Hồng Vinh. Nguyễn Bội Minh Khánh. Nguyễn Hải Yến. Nguyễn Minh Phương. Nguyễn Như Quỳnh. Nguyễn Quỳnh Như. Nguyễn Thị Mai Trang.
Nguyễn Thiên Lan.
Đây là Hưng à? Hưng. Đứng nít của anh.
Nguyễn Xuân Nghĩa. Nguyễn Việt Anh. Phạm Bích Diệp. Phan Minh Chí. Quách Quỳnh Trang. Trần Lê Phương Hảo. Trần Mỹ Linh. Trần Ngọc Thu Trang. Trần Trọng Nhân.
For the graduate certificate in tertiary teaching and learning.
Chứng chỉ sau đại học dạy và học chương trình đại học và cao đẳng. Nguyễn Thị Minh Tú. And finally, Trinh Thu Hà.
The Congratulations to all graduates. Chancellor, that concludes my presentation of graduates from the College of Design and Social Policy. Chancellor, Professor Peter Collow, Pro Vice Chancellor and Vice President of the College of Science, Engineering and Health, to present our graduate from the College of Science, Engineering and Health. Chancellor, I have the honour to present the graduate from the College of Science, Engineering and Health the degree of Bachelor of Information Technology with distinction. Trần Quỳ Hùng is also the outstanding graduate of the Bachelor of Information and Technology. Let's give an extra round of applause to Trần Quỳ Hùng. I too wish to pass on my congratulations to all graduates. Chancellor, that concludes my presentation of graduates from the College of Science, Engineering and Health.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes today's proceedings. Graduates, you are now part of the large community of RMIT alumni. I encourage you to get involved with the alumni community as it will enable you to stay in touch with the university and the friends you have made here, and to develop your professional networks to further your career. I take the pleasure of inviting you to join us in the foyer area for photos and refreshments after the academic procession retires. Congratulations again.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the removal of the mace and the exit of the academic procession.